You are about to start the audiobook of the book review of A Moveable Feast, a famous work by Ernest Hemingway. During this reading, you will first discover a brief context of the work and its author. Then, a summary of the work will be presented, followed by an analysis of the characters and the key points of the novel. Once these different points have been addressed, all that remains is to conclude this listening session with a few questions that may further fuel your reflection. The author. Born in Illinois in 1899, Ernest Miller Hemingway was a major 20th century American author. Several of his works are now classics, such as The Old Man and the Sea, for which he won the Pulitzer Prize in 1953. He was an adventurer and a traveler, and lived in the United States, Canada, Africa, France, Italy, where he joined the army after 1918, and Spain, where he reported on the Spanish Civil War, 1936-1939. Hemingway's novels were very successful and he won the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1954. He was married four times and narrowly escaped death in 1953 following a plane crash, but his health suffered severely from it. After staying in various hospitals in the early 1960s, he died on July 2, 1961. The book. Published posthumously in 1964 by the publisher Charles Scribner's Sons on the initiative of the author's last wife, Mary Welsh Hemingway, American journalist, 1908-1986. The book was published in a second edition in 2009, having been revised by Patrick, born in 1928, and Sean Hemingway, the author's son and grandson respectively. Although presented by the author as a work of fiction, A Moveable Feast has a strong autobiographical dimension, as it is simply an illustration of the joys experienced by Ernest Hemingway in the City of Light in the early 1920s, as well as in Switzerland and Austria. The book is made up of short chapters which each illustrate a relationship or an aspect of Parisian life, in which the author's joy and nostalgia are apparent. This love for Paris has a harsh echo in the will of the Parisians to resist terrorism after the attacks of November 13, 2015. Cited by an elderly lady during a widely shared television interview, A Moveable Feast has set new sales records since. Summary. The book is structured in 19 main chapters, the body of A Moveable Feast, with two other additional chapters and eight other unpublished chapters. We have chosen to summarize the content of the work in four main points, each examining certain elements of the various chapters: the many joys experienced by Hemingway in Paris, his friendships with Gertrude Stein, American writer, 1874-1946, and Ezra Pound, American writer, 1885-1972, his misadventures with Francis Scott Fitzgerald, American novelist, 1896-1940, and finally the rare moments in which he felt sadness at living in the capital. The joys experienced in Paris. Ernest Hemingway, his first wife Hadley Richardson, 1891-1979, and their son Jack, nicknamed Bumby, 1923-2000, moved to Paris at the beginning of the 1920s. They lived there for several happy years, despite their unpredictable income, at least until the author meets another woman to whom the beauty of the city pales in comparison. Due to his career as a writer, he spends a lot of time in cafes and restaurants, places he finds conducive to writing, as long as he is not disturbed. He truly loves these places for meeting and discussion, and describes their bustle and cheerful atmosphere. Additionally, the work begins with a scene in a cafe. The author is working there but, overcome with a desire to escape, he suggests a short trip to Spain to his wife. In several of the chapters, Hemingway also mentions bookshops, including that of Sylvia Beach, American bookseller and publisher, 1887-1962, and the secondhand booksellers along the Seine. The latter conduct their trade by getting hold of English and American books that have been left behind in hotels, which they then sell for a small profit. As this is the only place where the author can find novels written in his native language, he spends much of his time there. He also bets on horses with Hadley. Their bets reap rewards initially, which allows them to eat dinner at a restaurant, where they talk nostalgically about one of their friends, Chink. Hemingway, however, eventually gets bored of betting, which is not as profitable as he had hoped, and totally gives up this hobby. Their rare trips outside the capital are to Spain and to Schruns, Austria, where they decide to live after their son is born. Paris is in fact too cold in the winter for a baby. The couple also go to Switzerland, where some of the typical activities and the food leave a strong impression on Hemingway. He complains, however, about having lost his manuscripts during a journey to Switzerland. Hadley, who wanted to surprise him and allow him to work outside Paris, is devastated by this. Relationships in Paris. During the years he spends in Paris, Hemingway meets many renowned writers of his time. He thus spends a large amount of time with Francis Scott Fitzgerald, but also with James Joyce, Irish writer. 1882 to 19.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.